name is Danielle. This week's video is going to be a little serious, a little funny. We're going to talk about like 5 everyday struggles that fat people and fat women in general go through just in their everyday life that people don't think of. And just we don't openly talk about a lot.
I'm probably the laziest person you will ever meet in your life.
Oh, I better warn you. This is a gross part, so if you're grossed out easily, you don't mind the smell of your own farts, okay? Your own eau de toilette. It's just how it is. You know, like, oh, say you're home alone. You lift a cheek, you let one rip. You take a little sniff here and there, like, kiss to me. Clogged the toilet. It wouldn't flush. It overflowed. And he had to clean it up. My bowels had a sweet release. I could feel it everywhere. I had crapped my pants. And I seep through and come out the back of my pants. I needed help. I was laying there crying. Somebody help me, and people were just skiing by me.
Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. Yesterday to the hospital to have my imaging done, and they get me up on the bed, they get me strapped in because we're going in for an MRI, and they get me all situated and ready to go. They go to start pulling me into the machine, and I got stuck. So when you hear one of the pushing machines jammed and they couldn't get the machine to move forward or backward, I couldn't wig if I wanted to wig because there was no room to wig, so I had to lay there. Probably needed to tranquilize me because, I mean, my legs were shaking because I could not move inside the tube. So by the time they pulled me out, she just said, Amy, I'm so sorry. There's just no way of getting your body to go in and be able to do the circular pictures that we need done. It's not their fault. It's my fault because I didn't fit in the machine.
My name is Danielle, and today we're going to talk about periods. Specifically, periods when you're fat. Fat person down there is also fat. It can be a lot to reach around your belly to get things in there, and messy because also down there feels shut. Period gets stuck in there till you sit down in the toilet. It opens again, okay? And I actually tried a menstrual cup, and it kind of vacuum sealed itself to the very outside of it. When it comes to being sweaty and bloody down there, when you are working with dampness down there, it's nice to have something to grip onto in order to get the tampon in, okay?
I'm pretty sure yours was probably horizontal while mine was vertical, and mine was about 20 inches long, and I had absolutely everything taken out of me. Ooh, someone just said I faked cancer. Oh, that's fucking wonderful. I fucking wish. Dead by 31. People who say that are sociopaths. Like, they could actually kill someone and be totally fine. Because that's a psychotic thing to say to someone. That you're gonna be dead by 31? I feel like I'm in actual panic zone.
So what you're about to see is my weigh-in.
I'm Jennifer.
Hello. Hey, Clanny. 621.0 pounds.
I also want to say thank you to someone named Green. That was all that was on the tag, was Green. And it was something from my Amazon wish list. And it was
the praying mantis staff for $666.
Dank ass burgers, dank ass pizza, dank ass french fries, and dank ass nachos.
I'm trying to conquer my eating disorder.